And welcome to this first look at County Line. This is an American map. It is by KS Mapping. It was actually there was a previous version in FS17. I don't know if it goes any further back than that, but certainly I've had a look around this map. Previously in FS17, it was a nice map in that version of the game. So, yeah, I'm hoping for good things. It is a 4x map. It is unfortunately only available for PC, and it is available to download from the American Eagles modding website, which does require a registration to download it. But, of course, that is free. Yeah, we're going to have a look around it. It is a huge American map, this. As I said, it's a 4x map, so hopefully we're going to get it around it and have a look. And as you can see, I'm actually feeling... I drove the truck from the shop back to here. And this, of course, is Black Sheep Modding's truck again. And, yeah, it's... This looks and feels like a nice, big American map. It really does. It's just... There's this wonderful feeling of American farming on this map. And just driving around it is a pleasure to do. And you can see the fields go on for miles. But you've got farms all around you. You've got buildings you can see in the distance. The edge of the map is not an obvious thing, which is quite cool. And there's just a lot of detail to this map as well. Which is quite nice. And you see other farms here have all extra bits in. Because this is not a farm you own or anything like that. We will have a look at what you can buy and things like that. But it's... Yeah. That road just goes on forever. And again, that wonderful feeling of being on an American road in the Midwest... And just having these massive long roads with these fields that are huge. And it's just a gorgeous looking map, this. So much detail, so much character to it. Which is absolutely amazing. And this is the town. So this is the town at the center of the map. I'm noticing a few little drops in frame rate here. But I am running at a steady sort of 60 FPS. So, yeah, not sure quite what was causing that. In here is our first stop. This is a sell point. By the looks of it, a grain sell point. So I'm just going to have a look around. Yeah, in here. So, oh, lovely modeled sell point in this. Looking at these, I've seen stuff like this in Millennial Farmers stuff. So, yeah, that is really cool. I'm liking the detail. I'm really loving the detail in here. It feels like a populated place, which is absolutely brilliant. Here we got the shop, we got some John Deere's, and we got some cases. I think this would be a wonderful map to do something like a case farm on it. I'm very tempted to do something on this map. So if you'd like to see that, please let us know in the comments, because yeah, I think this is a map that's worth taking a bigger peek at and maybe doing some big farming on. Just from what I've seen, I mean, this is basically everything that I've done so far is drive around this. So, yeah, this is, wow. This is just gorgeous. This is one of the nicest American maps I've seen, I think. Really is. We're going to head north from here. We're going to head up to Wilkins Lumber and have a look up that side of the map. We'll be able to check out how the transition between the map itself and the edge of the map goes that way. But you can see here, more than one vehicle sales here. And again, feels like a really nice populated town. Just so much detail in it, which is just brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. And getting that big American feel, you know, if you want your maps big and American, this is a fantastic map, absolutely worth taking a look at. So I'm gonna ignore the various sell points and things we've got at the moment, because as I said, I want to head out to Wilkins Lumber. There is a railway line on this. I don't as far as I know, is not a functional railway line. It's not a line that you can use the train on. But you got... Now, that's an interesting thing. So, we have got... Ooh, I wonder if that works. Wow. Irrigation system. Now, on a lot of maps so far, irrigation systems like that, we've discovered, have been window dressing only. You haven't been able to use them. And that, to me, at this kind of distance, looks to be a similar setup. We will have a go with it later and see if we can do. Now, that's intriguing. Because that is a sell point in there that we cannot drive to. As far as I can see, there's no road. So what we're going to do is we are going to go a little bit off-road here and drive across. And have a look at the lumber yard. Wait. And see if there is a functional train here, which I'm not 100% sure. I don't think so at the moment. Would be cool if it was. But we've got... Yeah, we've definitely got something here. Whether it's functional or not, I'm guessing not, because... We've got a sell point here for wood, but nothing actually on the railway line. Again, it's nicely populated. There are diggers and cars and everything here. And this will give us an opportunity to head to the corner of the side of the map. Now, interestingly enough, yes, the map does go to a low-quality edge that you can get out of, but that you can't get out of. But looking at that, that is a lovely idea for hiding that edge of the map. You know, you get to here and it's still quite difficult to see that edge. You know, you're not just suddenly presented with it. I like that a lot. That is a really interesting way to do that. Especially with the trees at various angles. You do take a while to get there. And it looks like we have a route out here back up to the road. So we'll go and have a look. Yeah. So no functional train by the looks of things. Just the road sort of snaking round. And yeah, then a railway crossing here and back out onto the main road. So we'll head back this way and back to the main town. And again, we got this long road that just stretches out in front of us and is massively long. And this map feels big. Little bit of an issue with, I think, along the edge of the road here, where it could have been lifted up slightly. But to be honest, at this point, I'm looking for minor niggles. I'm really looking for those tiny bits, those really tiny bits of polish that are missing. I mean, this is a really well polished map. Don't get me wrong. It is absolutely absolutely gorgeous, the level of detail on this. Absolutely gorgeous. Right, we have a sell point here. So we've got a sell point along the road there, but we're going to have... Actually, yeah, let's go and have a look at what sell points we've got to the south here. So we have Black Sheep. So this is the Black Sheep wool sell point, I would guess. I would guess you could also sell cotton here as well. Very nice. And very easy to tell what that is for. And then... Oh, yeah. No, we do want to go back this way. Do we want to head up there? Yeah, we do want to head up there. We've got some stuff right up at the top of the map. But we also have an area in here. And I do like the different types of roads that we've got on this map as well. You know, there's a distinct change between the various types of road. This must be the garden centre. Looks like we have manure. Yeah, manure sales and manure purchase, maybe. And we've got a way out to a road there. Doesn't look like we have much else here other than manure purchase and sales. I would guess this might be where you... Oh, well, on previous versions, of course, this would be where you buy poplars and or trees and things in FS19, I don't think. I think you basically just buy them from the main shop. I don't think they're actually separated out anymore. So the garden centres don't have quite as much use on these old maps in 19 as they did in 15 and in 17. What have we got around here? So we got a sell point in here. Again, another nice big grain sell point. Looks like we have a sell point over there and a sell point down here. So the two that we can see on the map are both this location. So one there. And then the other one over here. And again, feels very lived in, feels like a working area. Absolutely fantastic. Head back up the road here, and even here, even though we're looking at the edge of the map, not in no way is that obvious you're coming to the edge of the map. Another sell point here, so this is biodiesel. I'm guessing that is where, you would sell canola and, is it through here? Yeah, it's through here. Canola and maybe corn. Again, nice looking building. Heading up the road to the top of the map now. And we are sort of motoring around this fairly quickly, but then it's a map that you can. So it feels massive, if you know, like that. But at the same time, it's got a good road network to it. You're able to navigate your way around it really quite easily. Again, the minor niggle of maybe the edges being pulled up a bit. In fact, is that... I just want to check, because I'm not sure whether that was... No, that is... So that's... I thought for a moment the road might be floating, but it's not. It is an edge. But it's just... I'll show you what I mean, is that I would quite like that to be flush instead of having this ridge. It's a little bit out of the ordinary for the road to be raised like that. But again, as I'm saying, that is the only thing I've actually found on here that I can pick at the moment. Everything else is just making me go, wow. Another sell point here. And again, county line grain. Good sell point as well. I'm guessing that is just for grain. We will go over all the sell points at the end of the video as normal, of course. And just have a look at what we have to sell certain things at. I'm going to pop down this road a little way here. I think we want to go down here because we want to get towards the animal dealer next. We've got a sell point in there. Hillside potatoes. So, separate sell point. The one thing that this map does have quite nicely is that it's got separate sell points. It's not just separate sell points. It's that it's got a large number of sell points. A good range of sell points. So, you have to go looking for your best price whenever you go to sell something. So, this is the potato sell point. Again, really nice looking sell point. This, a lot of detail into it, a lot of work, looking very nice. Bit of a strange bump in the road there, so again, a small niggle, a small item, not something that really sort of gets on my nerves too much. And then what looks like another sell point here, not marked on the map, this one. But yeah, there is definitely somewhere here that's smoking as well. It's possible that is one sell point for two different crops. But it was specifically a potato one, the other one. So yeah, I wonder if that's an error on the map with a sell point that is not marked. There's nothing marked there. So again, back on the roads. Good bit of detail to the roads. Nice textures, of course, custom textures for this map. And again, just adds that little bit Attleman's Livestock Auction. Let's head down here. And again, another change of road, blended in quite nicely with the sides. And again, a lot of character to it. I'm wondering if we have any kind of auction sounds, because I think I remember in the previous version that it's having auction sounds in here. Doesn't look like it. Again though, looks like an inhabited, looks like a working yard. Some nice deers on here. Here is animal purchase point. Now I would guess that this is an animal purchase point for just cows, which you can purchase everything here, but I've learned when we did RDC, I had lots of people telling me that, oh no, you can buy other stuff. You can only buy and load stuff in certain spots. So it's possible that this map works in the same way. That does seem to have a lot of cows in there. But I can't see another purchase point for animals. So maybe that is where you do all of your animals. Again, a very, very possible thing. So we'll head out of here. This actually takes us to a field. So we'll head back up this way. Again, another... could that be a sell point? If I remember correctly, there used to be a lot of silos and things on this map as well. So that is that distinct possibility too. So we're going to take this blue road now. Down here. And this should take us out... takes us out to the other set down the bottom here, where we have another set of sell points. I'm liking these fields. One of the nice things about this map is that it's got some really nice irregular fields. Again, adds character to the map. Now, this is another nice idea. Is putting another farm. So this is another farm at the side of the map. Doesn't, again, populated, doesn't look like one that you could particularly work very well if you owned it. I think I'd quite like to have seen that, is that these farm areas being ones you could buy and possibly populate yourself. It's one of those, it is a failing in FS19, I think, is that you can't buy farms with buildings on. I think I'd quite like to see that. I'd quite like to see... that places come with buildings on and you buy the land, you buy the buildings as well. They're not yours until that point. Would be quite nice. So we've got a whole set of sell points here again. I don't, at no point driving around this do I feel like I'm getting to the edge of the map. It's an interesting feeling. So we have a sell point here. This is for... this is a train yard, although again not a working train, so doesn't actually do anything other than be a sell point, of course. And then across the railway line and country living, and I think we've got one other here, so country living on this side. Farmers Bureau. What do we have on... so we've got a sell point in here. So this is Crisco. It would not surprise me, actually, if that took potatoes specifically. Safeway Supermarket over there. Is that our sell point? I don't think that is. It could be. I don't know where we sell eggs yet. Or this could be our sell point. Texas Barbecue. No, so which is the, should probably name it, Safeway. So it is the Safeway that is the sell point. And I would guess it takes the eggs. Would not, that wouldn't surprise me. Not overly well marked, but I would think my sell point is here. I would like better marking, really, for that, for where the sell point is here, because that's a bit of a letdown. But again, I am looking for things now to pick holes in, because this map is good. This map is really good. Down here we have somewhere the other side of here. Ah, there we go. Can we get, I think we might be able to get through it down here. Now this looks like, okay, we're going to have to hop across, but this looks like a cow yard or a dairy farm. Maybe, or maybe the sheep, looking at that icon, it could be as well. Yeah, I think this is our sheep. So that is, that's a sheep farm. So that's, I like that a lot as well. We'll bring this back out this way. And there is another sell point down the road there. So we're going to head back up to the supermarket and head down the road along the edge there, because we do need to head... Well, that's the it's the dairy down that way. We should be able to cut back across the farmland, I think. Most of the fields have roadways between them. So there's lots of routes that... So all the main roads are marked on the map. There's lots of routes where the roads aren't, and where it's harder to see, and where you need to kind of go around and see if you can see it. So here we go. Here's the dairy. Where is our dairy sell point? Must be around here somewhere. Not 100% sure. We're sort of dancing around it at the moment. That's interesting. Something, oh, we've got a floating light. that's not good. Well hidden floating light. That's not obvious. And it's only because I'm sort of searching around and doing stuff. But yeah, there are errors on this map. It does make up for it by being gorgeous. By looking utterly amazing. And here we go, road down the way here. And again, looking at the edge there, that's probably the worst I've seen the edge on this map look so far. Now, to me, it looks like we have a red dotted line further down here. If we can get through this tree line, we can cut across to Crystal Sugar. So it looks like we're doing a little bit of off-roading through some forestry. And again, this will give us actually a little bit of an idea of how much attention to detail is paid on this map. And yeah, as I always said, how the forestry area is treated tells you a lot about a map. And there's a lot of nice variation in this forestry. It looks cool. It's got the right texture on the ground. It's got a few bushes in there. And it adds to the character of the map. So always a good thing. And then we've got another one. Then we've got a road through this one. Yep, there we go. Roadway. Roadway goes down this way. It looks like it's more of a path. Doesn't, yeah. Not an easy one, this. And this is then a little bit more plain. So that's interesting. I'm not sure I'm a huge fan of that woodland area. But it certainly, there seems to be some attention paid, detail paid. And yeah, another irrigation setup like this. So with any luck, we should be able to see if this is functional. I'm not thinking it is, if I'm honest. I'm thinking that this is like the one we saw on Alien Jim's map. I doubt there's anything on here. Yeah, there's nothing on here that makes that functional. Still, lovely bit of window dressing. Absolutely brilliant. And looks good. Down this way, out through. So everywhere I drive on this map, there is something in there. So we've got the power station there. There's always, I look in any direction on this map and it, I don't get bored. There's no boring direction to look on this map. Which is absolutely brilliant. You know, there's a lot of eye candy on this map. There is not a single boring direction to look on this map. That is really something quite special to achieve. Looks like we have sugar beet here. I'm guessing. Those, yeah. those look like sugar beet. A bit crude in their texture. That'd be nice to be better to have a nice texture on here, but I'm very much thinking this is the sugar beet. Let's just have a look around here. American Crystal Sugar Company, of course. Yeah, American Crystal. Would not surprise me, actually, if you could sell sugarcane here as well. So back down this way, and away we go. And we're heading right down to the bottom of the map now. And this being a 4x map, it is taking us a while to get round. Longer than I'd originally thought, to be honest. Right, and then we've got another farm down here. This looks to be the pig farm. And again, a nicely rendered farm, a nicely created farm. Yeah, that is our pig farm. And looking great, looking fantastic. Pig food point, and it's an indoor pig farm as well, which is wicked. Now, I did see there was a map I played in FS17 that had one of these in that was an absolute pain in the butt to use. So, is that a sell point? Or is that the point that you unload? That could be the point you unload straw for the pigs, because can't see anywhere else. Looks like everything is nicely marked up on here, though. So that gives me hope that is not as much of a pain to use as the one that I saw in FS17 was. Down here, and we're going to take a left turn along this road here, because we have another sell point along the bottom. This is just a gorgeous map. Really, really lovely map. Does have its issues. And I'm not going to shy away from that. Does have its issues. But the ones on this map I can get past. I think this is our BGA. Yeah, this is our BGA. So biogas plant, digestate, purchase point or loading point, sell point for the silage, and then we got our silage clamps there. We are going to head along the bottom. We want to head down to the horse ranch before we loop back up to what I think is going to be the cows and home. So a little bit longer video this one, because it is a 4x map. And as always with Farm Sim, we get to the edge of the map and it doesn't quite know where to put the marker for our vehicle. Horse ranch. And again, this is just, you look around and it looks great. It's an interesting map to look at. Now, where's our actual horse ranch? That is, wow, again, this feels nicely lived in. There we go. Our horse ranch. So this will be a new addition for the FS19 version of this map. And yeah, there's your unloading point for horses. There is your water trough and your feeding trough. And that is where your straw goes. Fantastic. Everything you could want with your horses. Now, I would guess there's a riding area around here somewhere then. Can't see it, but it would make a lot of sense to me for that to exist here. Sort of a jumping ring or something like that. Very shiny lake. That's looking a bit... I'm not sure about that water texture. It is a nice shiny lake and a good amount of... good amount of shine, but that is oh wow, that's just like looking into the abyss. Yeah, I'm not sure about this water texture. That looks like a giant pool of oil. that's not great. That isn't, no. So really isn't great, that water. I think I'd quite like to see an update to that. I like how shiny it is, but that does just look like a giant pool of oil. Right, cows, I think, are directly ahead of us. And in fact, looking at the time that we've been doing this, that is probably a good place for us to halt the tour itself and to take a look at what else we get. But yeah, this is the cow ranch. This is the dairy farm. Lots of good buildings for us to use. Well, I would guess, yeah, I'm not sure exactly if that's a fuel tank or not. But everything to the cows is over here. Is it all on the outside, or is there anything you need to go in to do? Slurry tank, manure point. I would guess you do need to go into the fields to feed them, because I can't see anywhere outside of the field at the moment. Mind you, I can't see anywhere inside the field either. So I think that would bear further investigation. Where do you feed your cows? Because there's got to be somewhere. Oh, hang on. In here. Ooh. That's not a gate sound. Yeah. Disappointing. So, I would guess, is where you do that kind of stuff. Where you feed. Yeah. Wrong sounds on the gates. What is it with recent American maps and bad gate sounds? That's just unfortunate, is what that is. There we go. Wow. So, yeah. I think that's where you feed your cows. I'm not 100% sure. And that would take further investigation. So, we're going to park this up here. And let's go and have a look at what we start with. We are on New Farmer. And let's see what is in our garage. That's it. Oh, wow. Oh dear. So, this map, I started off with this map really excited and really happy with it. It looks gorgeous. Why do we only have the farm boots? So that is how we've got our home position, is the farm boots. We got the lizard pickup, which we added. So there's no equipment on here at all. That is unfortunate. I really, really wish that as a New Farmer, I won't play this in New Farmer, but I really wish that somebody coming to this map for the first time had some equipment. Which then begs the question, what fields do we own from the start? And at this point, I'm beginning to think it's a mistake that we don't own any fields, because, oh, we don't own any equipment, because we have field 10 and 11, and they're both ready to harvest. So both wheat fields, both ready to harvest, with no equipment and 100,000. So you're going to have to, if you start a new farmer and you're not adding anything in, you're going to have to rent equipment to start with, because these fields are huge. Absolutely humongous. Let's have a look at some prices. So yeah, you start with the main farm area, fields 10 and 11. Field 10 is 236,000, 138,000 for 11, and 231 for the main farm. Our biggest area to purchase on the map, I would have said, is either 30 or 26 by the looks of this. So 1.2 million for one, for 30. Or 90, yeah, so the biggest area to purchase is field 30. So you need 1.2 million for that. The smallest would appear to be, what's that? Field 20 looks like pretty much the smallest field for 95,000. So you could conceivably, you could conceivably get started by selling maybe 10 and 11 and then buying a couple of smaller fields to get yourself going. Field 20, I would have said sell field 10, buy field 20, and you can get equipment that will allow you to run those two fields straight off the bat. I think you're going to be hard pushed otherwise. It is a pity this map does not start with equipment. However, it is a beautiful looking map. A really beautiful looking map. So I'm impressed with how this map looks. I'm impressed with its attention to detail. It has issues. The floating light, really, we had to dig rather deep for that one. The sides of the roads, again, I'm willing to forgive those. I'm not a fan of the gates. Why put anachronistic sounds on gates? Not good. Still a map. Interestingly enough, though, still a map I'm interested in playing. Still a map that has so much going for it that I'm interested in playing this map. So, as I said at the start, I am intrigued. What do you guys think? Do you think that I should have a series or have a go on this map? Because I think it would be a great one for a whole load of big equipment. And as I said at the start, this is this is County Line FS19. It is by KS Mapping. It is available to download from American Eagles Modding for PC only. The link will be in the description to download where to download it. You will need to register to do that. I like the look of this map. It needs an update. It does need some fixes to it. None of them are game breaking, so I would be happy to play this and get them later. None of them are so horrible that they mean that I would have that it would affect how I played or really niggled me. It's for the most part is a great map. A little bit of work, it could be a fantastic map. But that's where I'm going to leave it. And all that remains is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for all the latest videos and live streams, please subscribe to the channel and ring that bell. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.